We don't care who likes it or not, as long as we know it's the truth. As long as we know it's the truth.
Are you following me? Not be stupid. There's 15, 20 of us in this room. Somebody in here is the agent. Don't start looking around. But somebody in here is just in here that's going to take this information to the government. And we can't be stupid. Everywhere we go, is that one person that's in the audience that's going to take that information back. And we got to know and understand that's just a reality. Until we set up infrastructure to deal with their ass, they're going to be here. Support the brother, love y'all to death, love y'all to life, man.
I got so many things working against me. Servants and merchants of death working intensely with the purpose to lynch me. A young person who feels like I've been on earth for a century. I was questioning my worth before the birth of this entry. I walk on cursed surfaces where merciless men be, who shirk the love I send and reimburse it with envy. What once was a full vessel is now worthless and empty. Recollections of sin tempt me through superlative memory. See, you'll be still fronting and worshiping jewelry while I'm trying not to let the force of gravity pull me to disaster. Evil forces I'm trying to master. My blood is draining faster. I'm living on plasma, trying to stay calm and drop this gun clip out of my palm. Trying to keep the governmental microchip out of my arm. And at this rate, can we advance? Hypothetically, a chance. Getting sicker from eating food that's genetically enhanced.
Don't get locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Trick aside in the blood doctrine.
Keep your name up off the blood doctrine. Keep your name up off the blood doctrine.
Don't get locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Trick the sign of the blood doctrine.
Trick the sign of the blood doctrine.
Keep your name above the blood doctrine.
The gift that God gave me saved me, but never truly paid me. I need angels to show up daily with harps to serenade me. My motivation escapes me, and I can't relate to a world that hates and tries to recreate me. So they disassociate me from the masses. So I patiently wait till time passes. I sit in the back of the class, unnoticed in dark glasses, watching these ignorant bastards boast and show gall. Allowing them to shine, knowing I have the power to kill them all. Yet I fall back with deep humility and stay my hand. The book said a prophet has no honor in his own land. So I expand expediently far beyond the sea. Forced to leave because my own tree wouldn't respond to me. Mistreated the women who bled, put wisdom in your head. Trying to duck and dodge the faulty education I was fed. I'm the sun, the moon, the star, and all in between. The fire, the water, the deep dream, the black king.
Don't get locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Trick aside in the blood doctrine.
Keep your name up off the blood doctrine.
Keep your name up off the blood doctrine.
Don't get locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Trick aside in the blood doctrine.
Trick aside in the blood doctrine.
Name above the blood doctrine. Man, they got you. One drop, they only need an increment. Universally recognized through distinguishment of your fingerprint. Freedom relinquishment, known in every single precinct you're in. Tapping instruments, hear your plan soon as you think of it. They snatch you and violate embedded God rights. Then they catch you with paper trails and credit card swipes. Make you contemplate if it's real and worth the whole deal. Population management through use of birth control pills. You signed it, and now it ain't nothing they can't do to you. Depending on what computers do. Fiending for pharmaceuticals. A hand, a shaitan raise and damage you for days. The evangelistic wave of a man with wicked ways. You signed it, the hell-driven covenant for instance. Loving the system, enlisted for government assistance. You figured the best name was the name that he was giving you. Exhibit your loyalty every time that you give a signature.
Don't get locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Trick aside in the blood doctrine.
Keep your name above the blood doctrine.
Keep your name above the blood doctrine.
Don't get locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Trick aside in the blood doctrine.
Trick aside in the blood doctrine.
Keep your name above the blood doctrine.
There's a lot of states around the country that are really, really beginning to see increased activity among their people for the freedom fight. And I really think it's going to continue. And I'm not pessimistic at all, Alex. I do believe that we can win this thing.
Well, I agree with you, and you know, for those that just tuned in, we're not joking about this. This is so hardcore when you've studied the facts and what the feds even admit they're doing, and they've already stolen so much money and done so many illegal things. They're not backing off. People need to understand, just like other countries have fallen to tyranny, it's happening here, and everybody needs to hit their knees and pray to God to also, you know, give them discernment. And people need to realize all of you are leaders in this fight. Whatever you can do now to spread the word, that what's happening in Washington is illegal and the solution is at the states, and that the globalists are going to pull out every dirty trick they can. I had a caller earlier that trains law enforcement in Texas, and he said what you had just said. In fact, it's incredible. He said that they're training at the fusion centers and getting the hardcore killers from Iraq and selecting, you know, kind of the lunatics that have been mentally, you know, broken down by 3, 4, 5 tours, and that they are forging them as pretty much a school of America's takeover operation, secret police, torture, everything here in the United States. And he wanted me to ask you about that and school of America's.
Well, I've heard these things, and I certainly do not discount them. In fact, Joel Skousen, in his most recent newsletter, he mentioned that as well. And Joel, as you know, is as well-researched as any man in America. I think that that is going on. But again, I want to focus on what you just said, and that is the answer is a resurrection, a revival, a resurgence of state independence and sovereignty. The founders were so wise. Whenever the Constitution was created in 1787, the states did not surrender their sovereignty. They still maintained their independence. And I think that at the end of the day, Alex, it is going to be the state governments, the governors and the leaders and the people of those states are going to stand up and they're going to put this new world order in their place. And I tell you, I do think that they're worried about that. And that means that we are on the right track.
God bless you. Stay there. Chuck Baldwin's our guest. We'll give you his website when we come back. Chuck Baldwin, you've got the floor in the last 5 minutes. ChuckBaldwinLive.com. You've got your Top Secret America, the Rest of the Story article out that's excellent. I'm glad you reminded me about Joel Skousen. Of course, Cleon Skousen, his uncle, wrote The Naked Communist, or was it The Naked Capitalist? I forget, exposing the whole banker takeover. And he's a great guy. I'm going to get him on about his intel about using the troops in Iraq domestically. But that's now all admitted. But in closing, Obama is dropping like a rock. The globalists are cornered rats. They're not invincible, but so many Christian churches have been taught that it's the end of the world, so we should just lay down and go along with Romans 13. As a pastor, what's your view on that?
Man, you just hit my hot button, Alex. I tell you what, we would not be in the shape we're in today if the pastors in America had not just laid down on the job. Some of it's the 501c3 tax-exempt status. Some of it is just plain old-fashioned laziness. Some of it is ignorance, but whatever the reason, you know, they have used that Romans 13 mantra for so long to sedate the churches of this country and to cause them to be lethargic, and they're using it against us. And I'm sure that for some of them it's not intentional, but boy, that result has been, for the most part, the Church of the Lord Jesus has been totally ineffective in standing against the forces of evil in this country. And I don't see a lot of turnaround on the horizon in that regard either. And that's why I think that God is raising up people like Alex Jones and the Ron Paul Revolution and Campaign for Liberty and a lot of these other groups that are out there that are standing against the New World Order, and they're standing for the things that are right. If the churches and the preachers had been doing it all along, we wouldn't be in this shape.